Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with chapter 7 of microwave engineering, where we are analyzing the microwave transmission line. So to analyze the microwave transmission line, very first of all, we have gone through the learning of the equivalent model with respect to the transmission line that has involved the lumped parameters as like the R, G, L and C. So along with the operating frequency, we have seen how the transmission of information can be there with respect to the knowledge of characteristic impedance also, the load impedance also over the transmission line. Next to that, we have solved the equations with respect to the microwave transmission line. The solution, we have the reflection coefficient and the transmission coefficient we have further derived, and based on to all these concepts we have also solved few of the numericals also. Now with the knowledge of standing wave that we have seen into the recent previous video, where we have the performance measurement in terms of the standing wave ratio, let us have a simple problem here. So here we are provided a problem statement with respect to the standing wave ratio here. The problem statement is, a transmission line has characteristic impedance of 50 plus J times 0.01 ohms and it is terminated in a load impedance of 73 minus J times 42.5 ohms here. We are asked to determine the value of reflection coefficient into part A and the standing wave ratio into the part B. As compared to the very first problem in the chapter, we have the load impedance and the characteristic impedance to be the given values. So the characteristic impedance is represented as capital Z sub 0, whereas the load impedance with this value is provided to us with the representation Z suffix L. So very first of all, we shall be noting down these two values and we'll be calculating the value of reflection coefficient. So here we have the given value of, I mentioned, Z0, that it is 50 added with J times 0.01 in terms of ohm, whereas we have ZL is equal to 73 minus J times 42.5 in terms of ohms again. Now we require the determination of reflection coefficient. So for part A, the reflection coefficient that can be denoted by gamma is expressed by the formula where we have the numerator ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0 here. So the difference between the load impedance and the characteristic impedance along with its addition is required in the corresponding numerator and denominator of the reflection coefficient. So by the next step, we substitute the values. We have 73 minus J times 42.5 as ZL. So this we have subtraction, 50 plus J times 0.01, it is the value of Z0. In the denominator, we put again 73 minus J times 42.5, and this is added with, we have 50 plus J times 0.01 here. Now after the substitution of the values like this, we calculate the reflection coefficient gamma. This is equal to 0.377, the magnitude, and angle it is minus 42.7 degrees here. So for obtaining this answer, we have made the conversion from the complex representation A plus J times B into the polar representations where the magnitude and the angle can be determined. So after taking the division into the same domain, we obtain this answer where magnitude is 0.377 and the angular value is of minus 42.7 degrees there. So this becomes the answer for part A. Getting back to the problem statement, here we are successful to determine the value of reflection coefficient. Now for determination of the part B, we require the standing wave ratio. Now see here, the standing wave ratio in the part B, as before, we shall be denoting with the help of symbol rho here. And now we know the relationship of the standing wave ratio with respect to the reflection coefficient here, because the standing wave is occurred because of the presence of reflections there. So rho is expressed in terms of reflection coefficient as the numerator 1 plus mod of reflection coefficient, in the denominator 1 minus mod of reflection coefficient here. So the substitution of the answer from part A, where we need to take only mod, that means the magnitude we require only. So we make 1 plus the magnitude from the part A answer, it is 0.377. In the denominator also, we shall be taking 1 minus 0.377. So this becomes 1.377, and here the subtraction will also result here. So therefore, the ratio corresponding to the value of rho that represents the standing wave ratio, we obtained 2.21 here. So here I outline this particular answer here. So here we are finished determination of the answers for part A and part B corresponding to the reflection coefficient and that of the standing wave ratio. By the next lecture, we shall continue with the same chapter, that it is microwave transmission lines, addressing the topic line impedance and admittance. So for more information and the details of the concepts related to microwave engineering, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.